Hello again. We are going to take a look at the second RTF malicious sample. Now this one is heavily obfuscated, so it will take some time, about 30 seconds before it's completely parsed. And in the rest of the video, I will cut out these dead moments. You see a very, very long list, more than 300,000 entries. So let's filter for objects. And there are no objects to be found here this time. So let's use Jara to see if we can find out something. I'm not going to run it on hex first because I don't know if it contains actual objects or Xcode. Let's just run the RTF Jara rules on the RTF file itself, so without decoding any potential hex. Okay, and we have something. We have detection for a string P fragments. Now P fragments, that is a control word that is used in RTF documents. And there is an exploit for P fragments in the Windows RTF parser, the Microsoft RTF parser. So what do we have here? So of course we have the level one, the RTF document itself that contains the P fragment. But then we find it here in these objects, which appear to be nested. This one here contains 662 hexadecimal digits, and this one 661 hexadecimal digits. So let's first take a look at this one here. We are just going to select it, not yet decode the hex, just select it and see what we can discover. Yeah, okay, that here is a lot of obfuscation. And here we have hex code, hexadecimal code. Yeah, and this here with the P fragments here, and we're SVSV, and this thing here. This looks like a typical exploit for that parsing of the P fragments control word. Yeah, more obfuscation, and here we have the control words. Okay, so let's take a closer look at the hex code here. I forgot the number. I'm going to go back here to my previous command and ask for hex decode. And here we see a URL, HTTP, and also here command.exe. This could be shellcode, and here this could be a small nopsnet, 9090, and so on, nops. So it starts at position 35. So let's extract this. So let's cut this at position 35, and then we want everything until the end of the data. We want to dump this because we are going to run this through the shellcode emulator. So let me pipe this into shellcode.bin. .vir. Okay, and let's now use the shellcode emulator. Yeah, and it is indeed again shellcode that is a downloader. We see URL download to file from this URL to this file, .exe file, and then it is executed, not straight executed, but this time through command.exe, and then an exit.